all right, here's the situation. You come out to your car, you turn the key, you or whoever, you know, the licensed driver is, turn the key, nothing happens. Or you hear a clicking noise. That either one of those means your battery's dead or your alternator's bad. We're going to talk about both those things here in this Hudson how-to video about how to jump a dead battery. So first things first, why might you hear a clicking noise when you turn your key and people tell you your battery's dead? It's your engine trying to turn over, trying to make those pistons work, and it doesn't have enough energy to do so. This can either be caused by your battery going bad, a couple cells of it going bad, or if it's just been sitting around for a while, if the alternator hasn't had a chance to charge it, it might have just run low on charge, might just need a jump, and then it might be okay. Either way, once you get your vehicle back up and running, you're going to go to an auto parts store and have them test your battery and tell you what's going on. So I'm going to pause the video, set up a better angle on the battery, talk about some of the stuff that we're seeing here. But before I do that, you're either going to need to jump your vehicle with jumper cables, or you might be lucky enough to have something like this. This is essentially a battery pack for your car. Back when I owned my Jeep, and it was pretty good at leaving me with a dead battery for one reason or another. My father-in-law actually purchased this for me. Works as a light on the front, but also you can plug it in, charge it up, and it's a battery jump pack for your vehicle. So this is really convenient to have around, but they're kind of expensive. So normally you're not going to have one of these. You do want to make sure that your vehicle has jumper cables. So that's going to be step one of this, is somebody in this situation needs to have jumper cables. And if you don't have one of these battery packs, you're going to need two vehicles. So I'm going to pause the video, talk about everything else, and see you in just a second. All right, so now that we're looking down at the battery, want to talk about the positive and negative terminals before we move on to how to jump the vehicle. So first things first, when you look at your vehicle or your parents' vehicle, whoever's that we're dealing with here, you might want to go check it now before there's any issue with the battery, especially since we're heading into winter and the colder weather. Now is the time when things are going to start to fail because it's harder to operate at colder temperatures. So if you see any corrosion on the terminals, and that's these points sticking up here, these are called the terminals that stick out of the battery. We have our positive and our negative terminals here. But if you see any corrosion on those terminals, you're going to want to try to clean that off and probably go have your battery checked now. Sometimes corrosion on the terminals is an indicator that acid is leaking out of your battery and that your battery may have gone bad. So yeah, go ahead and check your battery now before you have any issues. It's always good to do some preventative maintenance. But how we figure out which terminal is positive and which one's negative is it's marked. There's no guessing involved here. On our battery, there is a negative symbol here, and if we moved our positive terminal connections that go this way, there is a positive symbol there. Now, always, as you see, I'm not touching any of those metal parts. Never safe to do that. Even if you have gloves on, we want to try to avoid actually touching the terminals ourselves. General rule of thumb is if it involves electricity, don't touch it. So we're going to move the camera again now that we know which terminal is which. So again, the positive terminal and the negative terminal. If you can't tell any indications on the battery, it's worth checking twice or three times. Check on the sides, check on the back if you can see anything. Use a flashlight. But often the positive terminal will have kind of like more going on. So as you can see here, there's a few things attached to the positive terminal, whereas the negative just goes one direction. So we're going to pause the video, turn it around, and we're going to talk about how to jump this thing. All right, so like I said earlier in the video, you're going to hope that either your vehicle or the vehicle that stops to help you, your friend's vehicle, whoever it is, that one of you have jumper cables. So assuming that somebody's got jumper cables, here is how we're going to jump a dead battery. Now again, do not touch things that involve electricity. Jumper cables have alligator clips on both ends. We've got positive, we've got negative, and we're going to start at the dead battery. So black is going to correspond with negative. And we're going to connect our black clip to our negative terminal. Now, I'm not going to actually attach anything today because my battery's fine. It does not need jumped. And we're going to use an imaginary good battery. So let's say the good battery of the other vehicle is out here. The biggest thing that I can say about the good vehicle is keep that vehicle running. The reason that we're connecting clips between the vehicles is we're going to draw power from the good vehicle into this vehicle to hopefully give it enough to start and get its alternator running to charge its battery. So if you turn off the good vehicle, that good battery still has its energy, but as soon as we hook it up, it's going to draw energy and might very well cause that vehicle to not be able to start. And if this vehicle doesn't have enough energy, you're left with two dead batteries, which is definitely not good, because then we're going to need a third, friend or nice person that stops to help out the situation and hope that you don't do that again. So keep the good vehicle running, and we're going to connect the black to the negative of the dead battery. Now, the whole time, somebody should have been holding these jumper cables. So if I didn't say that in the previous video, because I've shot this a couple times, this is a two-person job, ideally. And if you have two vehicles, you're probably going to have two people. So one person is standing by the good battery, just holding the terminals, you know, waiting, being told, we're waiting to be told what to do. After somebody connects the dead battery's negative terminal to the black wire, we're going to go over to the good battery and do the same thing. Black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the good battery whose engine is running, right? That engine is still running right now. We're going to come back to the dead battery, take the red alligator clip and clip that to the positive terminal, making sure that we get a nice good clip. Don't clip on any of the like weak or like flimsy metal. Excuse me, we're clipping right onto the terminal. Then we go over to the good battery, same thing. Now the thing I will caution you with here is that's electricity, right? So electricity is going to jump from that battery into this alligator clip. Excuse me, if you take your time with it, you might see some sparks crossing back and forth, and that's just the electricity jumping to make the bridge. So get that clip on there, get it secured, but don't play around with it, right? When you do this, you might hear that. Here, I'm going to clip this onto this box that I have over here. When you do that, you might hear that engine actually change its idle. It actually might kind of like get a little weaker for a second, and that's because this vehicle is going to start to draw energy and start to try to like charge back up. If a person jumps into the dead vehicle right now and tries to start it, may not work. You may need to let this draw more energy and charge back up. So don't hop in the vehicle and just crank. If it doesn't start, it doesn't start, and just leave it be. Let it sit for a minute or two. Run that other vehicle. In the good vehicle, you could turn off air conditioning or turn off anything that might be pulling extra power to try to let as much power come into the dead battery as possible. At the end of the day, if jumping the battery does not work, you might have a larger issue here. But like I said at the beginning of the video, after you jump your dead battery, let's assume you get that engine running again, you are going to the AutoZone, the Advanced Auto Parts, NAPA, wherever you want to go to get your battery tested. It should be free. Go get your battery tested. Figure out, is it your battery? Is it your alternator? Is it something else altogether? So that is the basics on how to jump a dead battery. After you've gotten the good battery running and you need to disconnect your wires, we do everything in the opposite orders, right? So we literally reverse the whole process. We disconnect from the dead battery to make sure that that vehicle is running on its own now. So we take that positive clip off of the dead battery, hold it. Don't let it drop, because remember, this has electricity running through it from the good battery. So again, two-person job. So you take it off the dead battery, you take the red clip off the good battery, and then you take your negative clips off, you coil up your jumper cables, put them back in whoever's vehicle is responsible enough to have jumper cables, and drive yourself to the auto store, get that battery checked.